Hey there, what are some freelance writing jobs that women can do? Answer, grant writing. At least that's the freelancing gig that I know all about and want to tell you all about. So in this video, we're going to be breaking down how do you actually get into this if you have zero experience. So this is going to be a breakdown of the method that we believe in so that if you think this fits for your personality type, you can go full send and get to your goals a lot faster than you might think. Okay, with that, let's hit it. Okay, number one, you can speculate all day long about if you would be good at grant writing, if you would like it, but I'm telling you, the only way to know is to get in there, take action, and try. And you have nothing to lose by learning a technical skill. And the weird thing about learning something new is that maybe it doesn't make sense right off the bat, but then it really comes full circle later. I'll give you an example. So when I was trying to figure out how to do a career shift, I wanted out of my corporate job, I ended up taking this, I thought I wanted to learn how to code. So I ended up taking a how to build websites course. It was super cheap, 8 weeks long. I actually dropped to part-time so I could dedicate the time to taking, you know, 10 to 15 hours a week dedicated to this online course. And then guess what? I didn't touch HTML and CSS. I didn't code anything on a website for 3 years until my boyfriend suggested, let's go prepare a new website for you. And it was so fun. I loved it. The skill came right back. It was so great. And I can still hop into my own website. I can make changes if I see something I want different, push it to production and it's live. And I'm so proud of that skill. But it was one of those things where I just made time for something new. And the only way you'll know you'll like it is to just get in there and do it. I could speculate all day long if I would have liked coding websites. And I don't know if I would have thought that, yes, I think I'm going to like this. I just had to give it a try. So, however, that said, I don't believe most people, when they think they need to go out and go try, they think, oh, okay, I gotta go find an organization to volunteer with. But I'm gonna go ahead and guess that you've got a lot going on in your life, right? You probably have a full-time job, maybe you have a family, right? You're volunteering, you've got just a life that you care about. You care about taking care of yourself, right? Getting outside, hiking, traveling, etc. So we just do not believe in volunteering. Maybe it's because I'm a product of graduating in the recession, and so I'm just really against volunteer work because I see it being a very endless cycle of abuse. So the different way to approach this is what we call the Grant Writing Unicorn method. So in this model, you learn your technical training, you get technically trained on how to write grants, but you also learn the business skills behind freelancing. And you figure out, all right, I am gonna go start serving clients and I'm gonna put together for them a funding strategy. A funding strategy is a roadmap to recommending to an organization, hey, here are the top grants I think you should pursue. You have the highest likelihood of winning and this is just the best return on your investment. You have pre-vetted those. And guess what? Putting together a funding strategy requires critical thinking skills and research. Not grant writing. Very nice. So you can gain your confidence and your experience and your comfortableness with the client, with the organization you're working with as a newbie, right? And we show you how to charge anywhere from $500 to $2,000 for a single funding strategy, which, hello, that also pays for your investment in, if you decide to learn with us, the Grant Writing Unicorn Collective. So the idea here is that you're getting your technical training, you're earning your certificate, and that's valuable. But frankly, that doesn't get you all the way. It's also, how do I actually make money doing this now that I have this technical skill? And that is not something that we're born knowing. Okay, third point I wanna make on this is that you have to build speed with the flywheel. When you want to make the transition from your crappy corporate job or whatever, I mean, I liked my corporate job. I'm not trying to hate on it, okay? But there were things about it I hated. So if you want to be kind of making this transition, pulling it off, recognize that there is a period there where it's kind of slow going. You're getting your training under your belt. You're figuring all this stuff out. You're getting your confidence. So it takes a little bit. It takes 6 months, 9 months, at the most a year. But on average, for most of the people that are in our program, it's 6 months when they're really hitting their stride. Don't get me wrong, they're making money doing funding strategies within a month or two or three. But in terms of like, okay, I am making enough that I could actually conceivably quit my job and feel good about it, right? So just recognize that you need to start before you're ready. You're never going to be perfectly ready. The stars don't align, right? I actually read a quote about this in some other video. So just recognize, get going before you realize. Number four, build this around your life. So how I like to do it is work my tush off for 7 weeks, take a week to break, have a break, go do a camping trip for a week, go do a mountain bike trip, go next week I'm gonna be going skiing, right? But I've been working for the last 7 weeks. So the idea here is that maybe you've got kids at home and you need to be, there's certain blocks, right? Picking the kids up at 3 p.m. and like it's chaos until 8, right? Well, you're not getting anything done at that point. But yeah, maybe you can get some hours in the middle of the day and you can work from, you know, 8 to 9 and crank out a power hour. So just recognize that you can build around your life. Maybe you're retiring and you're trying to figure out, well, how can I still have a little bit of income that I can do on the road? Big bit of news, you can do the grant writing anywhere because your clients just need you to have internet and you can communicate with them anywhere. So build around your life and be intentional about that. You're gonna wanna focus on, okay, well, what are the grant cycles? Maybe you focus on a specific program that you do year over year and you just find clients that you can go help pursue and you know it's in November, let's say, which is a month that you're not doing anything cool, so you don't mind being heads down and working really hard, right? But you know then that you're coming up for air and you're taking a trip to Hawaii. So just know there's a lot of ways you can architect this to work for your unique situation. So I hope I've painted a good general case in terms of why I think you should consider grant writing as a great freelancing gig for you as a woman, men as well if you're listening. Just know that number one, the only way to know is to give it a try. Two, get trained and get paid. Three, build that flywheel speed, i.e. start before you're ready. Four, build it around your life. If you found this helpful, be sure to hit the training that's linked below. Go into way more detail with slides on how this model works. Hit subscribe and add any questions you might have in the comment box. All right, that's it.